Hey everyone, it's Pixel Aidrail here, and welcome back to the channel. So we have some new details, some new information coming in from one of the developers on the BR-101 Expert Locomotive. I covered this post in my last video. This is a post from CWF Green over on the forums, but since then they have added some new bullet points to this list with more details than before. So I did watch the preview stream for this. I was fascinated. It looks very detailed, and I can admit they blew me away. They did a very amazing job at creating and programming this. I don't want to deter you from picking this up if this is something that you're interested in, but me personally, I am going to pass on it. It just seems a little too complex, and also given that it is a German locomotive, all the error codes for the faults and all that stuff are going to be in German, so I'm gonna have to refer to the manual pretty much 24/7. I just feel like for me personally, it's just gonna be a bit too much. It doesn't fully fit my playstyle for the game, but if that's the sort of thing you like, then I say pick it up, or honestly even grab it when it goes on sale eventually, because we all know that it will, because I do think the price is just a tad bit on the steeper side. I know they spent a lot of time working on this. From what I've read, like a year or something they spent working on this loco, which is a lot of time. I'm pretty sure they only spend a couple of months, what, 2 to 3, maybe 4 months per loco, so more than double the time. So I can understand why they're asking for more money, but when I'm looking at value for money, it just doesn't fully line up. Maybe if this was compatible on more routes, more timetables at launch, then that would be different, but the intercity cab car is only going to be available on 2 routes, though thankfully the BR-101 Expert will be on 5. So that does make it a little bit better. So now moving on to some of the new points that were added to this post by CWF Green. The cab car will be compatible with the Railpool Vectron DB-BR-111 and the DB-BR-218 on release. More are probably compatible, but I have not tested these yet. This compatibility is at a, in quotes, non-expert level, which means that you can do the normal stuff like control doors, traction, train lights, pantograph, main circuit breaker, and train line when applicable, but some of the special indicators or switches that require jumper cable signals will not function, since the jumper cable signals required for these only exist on the expert vehicles. Mixing the cab car with old intercity coaches is not supported. Again, I want to reiterate, this compatibility is on a non-expert level only. So if you want the cab car to be controlled by the Vectron, the BR-111, or the BR-218, it will be the standard or simplified version, if you will. I guess that's better than no compatibility at all, right? The next point being that the BR-101 Expert is compatible with most other locomotives, at least the Railpool Vectron, the old DB-BR-101, DB-BR-111, DB-BR-218, etc. However, the coaches may need to be broken up by a non-expert coach at release due to the locomotive not detecting all older locos. Some have incompatible setup that makes them invisible. This will hopefully be fixed in the upcoming patch. The compatibility is at a non-expert level. For example, the MU control, like ZDS or ZMS pantograph selection, will not work on the rear non-expert locomotives since they lack this compatibility. Certain MU indicators in the cab of the BR-101 Expert will be missing, again, since the older locos do not have this data. Honestly, I expected this. I didn't think that there would be virtually any compatibilities with any old stuff at all, honestly, even on a standard or simple level. So seeing that there's at least some compatibility does make me a little happy, but I definitely didn't expect it. A lot of players were actually asking about suspension for this release. We know that the suspension update is coming very soon. They said the end of July or early August. Well, guess guess what? Knock, knock. Early August is here, so suspension is coming very soon, and I cannot wait till that comes out. I can't wait to cover it, talk about it, review it. I'm gonna have a lot of thoughts on that, and there is a whole list of locos that are getting suspension, so that will be a video for another time, but it is confirmed here by this developer that suspension is actually not going to be included with the initial release of the BR101 Expert. They write, "I made the decision to wait for the suspension physics in the core game to be finalized before implementing these on the locomotive and the coaches slash cab car. The reason for this is that suspension is, in my experience, something that can be very much uncanny valley and divisive, so it needs to be, in quotes, perfect before it gets added to the vehicles." And I can understand why a lot of players would actually be disappointed by this, but I'm happy suspension is not going to be included with this at launch. We definitely do need to have that in the core game before anything is done. There's a lot that I could say on suspension. It's very disappointing how it was literally a main selling point for Train Sim World 4 at launch, with it coming eventually, and now we're probably, what, less than a month away from the announcement of Train Sim World 5? Speculation, if it happens to be announced, I'm just saying possible, and we still don't have suspension. It's kind of crazy that they made us wait this long for it, but I'm sure the team has the same idea behind it as CWF Green does here with this. When it's going to be done, if it's going to be done, it has to be done right. It literally has to be perfect. So I can understand why the team is taking their time on implementing it for core locos for Train Sim World 4, and I can totally understand why they're waiting for it for the BR101 Expert as well. So not upset about that in the slightest. And the next point, on initial release, the doors will open by themselves when unlocked and a platform is adjacent, and the doors that are opened are randomly selected as to simulate passengers opening the doors rather than all being opened and at the same time. But the doors still need to be closed manually by the driver. This is very important to know, because if you don't manually close them, they're not closing. I'm working on making this more realistic for a future patch. What this would mean is that the, in quotes, virtual conductor would use the UIC key, which is implemented and simulated somewhere in the train, to send a door lock signal that closes all the doors and then send a signal to the driver. I probably will end up picking up this loco eventually to give it a shot, though I personally just don't see myself enjoying it. It's not that I don't like highly detailed stuff. I love highly detailed stuff. If they did something like this for the ACS64 or for the Acela, I would eat it up, because it's US content. It's in English. I can read it. I can understand it. But because this is a German loco, it's just going to stress me out personally. I'm not trying to say this is bad, this is terrible. I understand why it's in German and why they're going to have it stay in German in the game, because it's a German logo. I just personally don't want my nose in a manual every time I'm playing the game. But if that's something that you want to do or you're okay with, I say go for it. Pick it up, give it a spin, see how you like it. So for the manual that's coming with this loco, how detailed will it be? Will it include how to fix faults? Manual author Raf is actually on the forums responding to some players, writing, "Yes, the manual will include how to fix faults." It goes without saying that this is going to be the lifeline of players. They write, "The BR101 fault section includes the translation of every fault message on the diagnosis screen in a similarly displayed manner, formatting a larger font for easier readability of the steps to take when in motion. The cab car fault section will include what to do for every fault light indication and the simple steps to take if a circuit breaker trips but does not result in a fault indication." So you aren't going to be in the dark if you don't understand the German language. There will be translations in the manual, which, to my knowledge, I believe that you can actually download the manuals even if you haven't purchased the locomotive. Don't hold me to that 100%. That's just something that I've read a couple of times on the forums. So when this does release, I wouldn't see why you wouldn't be able to download and take a peek at the manual before you commit to purchasing. Though if you do purchase, especially on Steam, they do have their great game guarantee, so you can always refund, but you can only do so though, in a limited window of play hours. I believe you only get 2 hours before you are no longer allowed to refund your DLC. I've done this several times for multiple Trains and World DLCs, and yes, it does work. If you're just not happy within the first couple of hours, Steam will give you your money back. I do want to give the team 10s where 10s are due, and for spending as much time on this loco as they have, and just judging from the preview stream, because they had the volume up kind of loud, which I'm very happy about because I wanted to pay attention to the sounds, they absolutely knocked it out of the park. The sounds are really, really good. I truly didn't expect to be disappointed there. It is important to note that Raf states the manual is lengthy. If you do decide to print it, at least initially, it might take over 110 pieces of paper, and there will be updates to it. So what you see when this releases will likely change, which I guess is a good thing. I'm sure they're going to be updating it with feedback, especially within the first couple of weeks. So how is the manual looking in its current state? Again, this will be updated and changed with time. Raf writes, I initially anticipated only about 120 pages. We have over 130 now due to more details and nicer graphics. The cab car faults and solving instructions are basically complete. During export, the table of contents will be used to create bookmarks. You can use bookmarks to navigate through the document easily with a PDF reader like Adobe Acrobat, and I expect other readers like Foxit are capable of that as well. There are hyperlinks at keywords to direct to certain chapters, and for screens, those being the MTD, the Ebula screen, and the GSMR panel, there will be page trees, schemes in which you can see all of the pages you have access to if you press certain buttons. So it is going to be pretty user-friendly and easy to navigate. Honestly, I'm going to be honest with you guys, the more that I read on this and seeing how detailed it is, and also how much work has gone into this manual for all the tiny aspects, which to some are huge, major aspects are simulated, I can understand the price, but personally will be waiting for a sale. You should be able to get your hands on the manual as soon as today, actually, because it is Monday now. I don't think I'm going to make a video going through that. It's just going to be way too long, and I might even update the description of this video or even leave a comment pinned with the link to it once it goes live, but you will be able to get your hands on it before the DLC drops. So hopefully that will help you make the decision that you need to make on whether you want to purchase this DLC at launch. But share your thoughts down below on what you think of the BR101 Expert Loco, and of course all of these new details. That's going to be it from me for now. Of course, I want to thank you guys so much for clicking and watching. Take care and happy real simming.